outright disdain. They see our leaders labeling fellow citizens enemies of the state while emboldening torch-bearing white supremacists.
Pause. What? What? White supremacists? I haven't seen one. There's been rioting going on. I don't think they exist. Burning down cities, going to white suburbs and terrorizing. I haven't seen a white supremacist yet. Give us some proof, you fucking liar. That's her message. This country is just, we have to fix it. It is so racist. You couldn't come up with anything new since you left the White House in shambles. How about your husband? The Marxist spying on the next president to come in.
Watch in horror as children are torn from their families and thrown into cages and pepper sprayed.
That was done on your husband. Remember they put pictures up? Somebody put pictures up on the internet? They trolled, some right winger trolled the left. They said, look what's going on under Trump. And then he went, haha, these are from Obama. When he was, and this is how he handled illegal immigration. She's fucking told five big fat lies already. Go ahead.
Bullets are used on peaceful protesters for
pause. She's complaining about Trump sending the federal troops to break up using bullets on peaceful protests. First of all, they're not peaceful. They're burning and looting. How many fucking lies can you tell? And I don't remember anybody getting shot. What is she talking about? Peaceful protesters? She's lying right to your face. Go ahead.
Sadly, this is the America that is on display for the next generation.
Better than when your husband left.
A nation that's underperforming.
Is that it? A nation that's underperforming. They had the strongest economy in the world before COVID hit. Underperforming. Actually got the respect back of a bunch of countries around the world who are envious of our economy. We put China in place. He wiped out ISIS. All shit that was created by your dope of a husband. You're a big fat liar. I don't like you, okay?
Who said that?
I did.
Who the fuck said that?
Michelle Obama.
Who's the slimy little communist shit twinkle toe cocksucker down here who just signed his own death warrant?
Michelle, I'm gonna say one more thing.
On the fucking kitchen and give me my big piece of chicken!
My favorite Chris Rock of all
time. I just got the fucking shit!
It's true. When I come home, I don't want to hear anything. When I get up in the morning, I can't hear yep. Next up is a former Republican. The guy was actually a contributor to Fox News. Former governor. I think he's former governor. John Kasich of Ohio. Remember this jerk off who can't decide? Finally jumped the fence. Now keep in mind, this is a Democratic candidate. This is his last gasp as a politician. No one on the left or the right. Let's listen to what Cheesedick has to say.
Because we're being taken down the wrong road by a president who is pitted one against the other. He's unlike all of our best leaders before him, who worked to unite us, to bridge our differences, and lead us to a united America.
I'm gonna kill you, you lying cocksucker!
He's standing, by the way, at a fork in a road. I don't think they show it at the beginning. They shoot that. He's literally at a fork in a road. Ooh. Fucking great metaphor, John. Go ahead. Oh, that was it? I don't even know what he said. Oh, shit in your hat, silly. Oh. Boy, did they.
they hate Trump. You know why? Guys like Kasich hate Trump. He's been in politics his whole life. Trump was there for 5 minutes and became president. This shit couldn't do it. You know why? Because you can't take a chance. I never trust people. Oh, I'm right down the middle. I'm not left or right. There are a few people who could say that, like libertarians, that mean it. But most of them is like, oh, you're afraid to take one side or the other. You're afraid to take a stand. Fuck this reaching over the aisle shit. The only time Republicans reach over the aisle is to choke somebody like John Kasich. Now let's listen to a friend of mine. I'm sick and the American people are sick and tired. I'm sick and tired. I'm in my late hundreds. I'm sick and tired. I haven't taken a good dump since 1972. Donald Trump is a racist. He's a misogynist. Take it out. Well, hold on. I have to play one. I gotta put in one more sound. Nobody watched because it's not like tuning into a big event with balloons and 10,000 people cheering. I mean, it was none of it. It was like a few. So, Mr. Trump, I bet you this is in the works. I'm like, you should go to Republican thing. I know. People want to go back to work. It was like a boring infomercial. So you should do it live. And if nobody, if none of the states will let you do it because of COVID, I'll bang a white UFC. I'm going to Fight Island. United Emirates. Oh, yeah, wait a minute. There's no crowd over there either. That's what I don't get. Like Fight Island. You know what to do, Mr. Do it live. The people will love it. So he mentioned, Barney mentioned the whole thing about the Postal Service, which is a bunch of poo-poo. Trump on Thursday said he opposes both election aid for states and emergency bailout for the U.S. Postal Service because he wants to restrict how many Americans can vote. You hear this? This is supposed to be journalism. Listen to all the anti-Trump sentiment. Because he wants to restrict how many Americans can vote by mail, putting at risk the nation's ability to administer the November 3rd elections. No, that's not why at all. Because it's been
proven over and over again. Mail-in ballots, it's right for fraud. Look at New York, they had an election 6 weeks ago. How about attacking mail balloting and the integrity of the local funds? But his latest broadside makes explicit his intent to stand in the way of urgently needed money to help state and local officials. The Dems want to open up.
Nick.
I know.
Fucking genius.
Anyways, yeah, so Trump is saying is holding back money needed to help state and local officials administer elections during the coronavirus pandemic. With nearly 180 million Americans eligible to vote by mail, the president's actions could usher in widespread delays, long lines, and voter disenfranchisement. His fault. Voting rights advocates said. No, you're doing that. We all know the pandemic is going to end, right? On what? November 3rd. Jerkoff gets elected. Trump said his purpose is to prevent Democrats from expanding mail balloting, which he has repeatedly claimed without evidence. What do you mean without evidence? We have plenty of evidence. They already found. He was on TV, Trump, a couple days ago. Some ballots already went to cats and dogs and dead people. You can look that up. He's saying it would invite widespread fraud. The president has also previously admitted that he believes mail voting would allow more Democrats to cast ballots and hurt Republican candidates, including himself. I think I probably read what he's just about to say. We got video, Rez?
It'll be the greatest fraud ever perpetrated, other than perhaps what they did to my campaign, where they spied on my campaign, President Obama, Biden, and everybody else.
I love it.
And they got caught. Let's see what happens. This will be one of the greatest frauds in history.
Thursday, Trump told reporters at the White House that he would not veto legislation that is funding for the Postal Service, but added that the reason the Post Office needs that much money is they have all of these millions of ballots coming in from nowhere, and nobody knows from where and where they're going. And you guys think that's lies and shit? I mean, that's something you can check up. The president is afraid of the American people, said House Speaker, saggy-titted, wrinkled-necked, self-entitled whore Nancy Pelosi. He said he's been afraid for a while. He knows that on the legit, it'd be hard for him to win. Pure Trump offered Joe Biden as he wiped his ass after taking a dump behind a mailbox, thinking he was in his bathroom. Presumptive Democrat presidential nominee, in response to the president's remarks, he doesn't want an election. That's what Joe Biden said.
You're a real cum-bum.
This is coming from a guy who hasn't come out of his basement. Come out twice in the last, he's the Democrat nominee, showed his face twice on TV, but it's Trump who doesn't want an election. Your sister's tits, your sister's tits, your sister's tits. The party is also working to train as many as 35,000 poll watchers. What are those strip club members? Hello. To monitor both in-person voting and ballot counting, mostly in key battleground states. Trump's claim about voting by mail have been echoed by Attorney General William Barr.
Counselor?
Who has repeatedly said without evidence that mail-in voting could lead to a high risk of fraud and interference by foreign countries. Without evidence, they keep saying without evidence. By the way, that's supposed to be, this is journalism in America. It's probably the Washington Post, it doesn't matter. I don't even disclose it anymore because it's all left-wing horseshit. Without evidence, they said that, what, three times an article? Without evidence, plenty of evidence. You're so caught in your little shithead bubble that you want to, you know, you can't handle the truth. Remember Joe Pollack? We had him on the show a couple weeks ago, Breitbart editor. Look at him, he's always happy. Looks like somebody just said, there's more pizza in the fridge. Pollock. Democrats go postal with busted mailbox conspiracy theory. Democrats have spent several days flogging the false mailbox conspiracy. That's what they do. They create a lie. They get ahead of it, you know? That the president, Donald Trump, is deliberately crippling the U.S. Postal Service so that it cannot handle votes by mail in November, even forcing it to remove mailboxes. Yeah, right.
Don't say a fucking word to me. I'll get up and I'll bury this telephone in your head.
The truth is that the mailboxes were removed because mailboxes are always being removed. About 14,000 were removed during the Obama-Biden administration. Did you hear that, shitheads? Useless idiots who vote Democrat? 14,000 of them were removed. They're always being removed. They remove the ones that don't get a lot of mail in them in small towns and shit because it costs the post office money. It's really a rocket science. Democrats are creating a new hysteria to cast Trump as a tyrant and motivate their conspiracy theory addled voters. Former Vice President Biden enthusiastically inflamed this phony conspiracy theory far more directly than Trump can be said to have promoted or encouraged the Kamala Harris birther theory, which he did not. Fucking, they got him saying that.
Danger, Will Robinson. Danger. No, Will Robinson. Danger.
The U.S. Postal Service has been a problem for years, like we've been saying, constantly losing money. In 2009, the Postmaster General proposed moving to a five-day-per-week mail delivery to cut costs. Barack Obama criticized the service that year for failing to keep up with private sector competitors, like, you know, FedEx and USB. The Obama-Biden administration considered closing nearly 3,700 post office locations and proposed cutting 12,000 postal jobs. Do you remember any of that, Joe Biden? Do you remember? I know you can't remember what you had for breakfast, but do you remember that? Brad. Pause. My apologies to Joe Biden. This was in my back pocket the whole time. And if this one's empty, you're gonna see me shoot himself in the head. I'm making this place. Good luck renting this place out when we leave. Anyways, where am I? President Trump tried a different track, demanding in 2018 that Amazon lower the prices it charged the U.S. Postal Service for delivering its packages to consumers. One aspect of ongoing cost management is the removal of mailbox from areas where few people deposit mail. Kimberly from... Kimberly, who's Kimberly? Who's Kimberly from?
Oh, wait. Is she a great big fat person?
Sounds like it. What a horrible name. Remember Kim Plum? Kind of fucking fat. A spokesman for the service told The Hill that low-volume mailboxes are regularly removed to cut costs. Sort of goes right to the Dems' theory, doesn't it? She said that low-volume mailboxes are a financial drag on the Postal Service, which lost more than $2 billion in the second quarter. It is a fluid process, and figures can vary from day to day. Historically, mailboxes have been removed from lack of use in remote areas. Okay? From a lady who works there. They lost $2 billion in the second quarter alone. But it's so outlandish to say they're going to fuck up mail-in balloting. They even said we can't handle the fucking traffic. Democrats, do you do anything above board? You lying cocksuckers. Seriously. A man goes to a post office, he leaves. We have some video from a woman. She put a video up showing you how, you know, they say you mail in your ballot, nobody can tell how you voted, Democrat or Republican. Well, she says it's full of shit. A postal worker can look at an envelope, she says, and determine what party you're voting for. So I do not know what state this is from, but what's up? Check this out. I didn't know this either.
Now, show you the comparison. Look at my brother's, who's a Democrat. It says 4212D. That's Democrat.
Thank you.
Then you go here, because we're both the same address anyway. 4212R. Okay, so your vote is supposed to be protected. Nobody's supposed to know what you're voting for, but yet they put R right here and D right there. So a postal person could see this if they're a Democrat and say, oh, that's an R. Let's toss it. Let's just.
I'm guessing they do vote Democrat. They work for the government most, you know. See that? They see it in our day. You don't want people who work in the post office know that? Of course they do. Nobody hand for that lady. She's terrific. She's protecting us.
I am your voice.
You are correction. A D there and an R. What state was that from? I don't know. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, a quick reminder. Make sure if you're watching my show on YouTube that you click the thumbs up button. Also, make sure you subscribe to the show and click the notification bell. We got another half dozen or so emails yesterday about people who were either unsubscribed or who had the notification thing turned off. So keep an eye out for that. That's what we're up against. But they wouldn't try to throw an election. Thanks also to those of you who chat live during the premiere at 5 o'clock. We rarely preach the ones that submit the super chats, like this one from yesterday, Castle's Keep. Y'all drop a super chat. We need Raz and Nick keeping the show going. Nick, give a shout-out to New York City Plumbers. I've been pushing your show. Well, thank you so much, Castle's Keep. You plumbers out there in New York, yeah! Shit runs downhill, am I right? That's what they always say. The only thing you need to know to be a plumber, shit runs out. Plumbers are amazing, though. Like, fucking, they go under my sink, they're there for 10 seconds. It's something I've been looking at for 2 years. It's more about me being retarded. The guy goes, well, you had 7 pounds of cat here in the drain, dummy. Drano don't work unless you pour it down a kid's throat. It never fucking cleans it. Thank you, plumbers. I can see all. I give a nice shout out to all your ass traps. Here's my dates real quick, barring COVID. September 12, 17 through 19, the Plaza Hotel and Casino in Vegas. October 2nd, Jonathan, Maine. October 10th, Stand Up Live, Huntsville, Alabama. October 11th, Zanies Comedy Club in Nashville, Tennessee. November 19th, The Improv, Raleigh, North Carolina. Go to nickanddip.com for thinking of a race. I haven't done stand-up since when? I think Magoobies, was that the last one? That very hard. I wouldn't know. If I had to go on the stage, I'd have to bring props. Look at my old sets. I gotta watch. I gotta refresh. I got about 8 minutes on Trump that were relevant. You know, 7 months ago. And put Raz Malcolm is right behind it. Use the colors. Thank you. E&R, Long Island, New York. Great show, Nick. Damn right. Thank you. Bye-bye. Been a big fan of yours for years and love hearing your truthful takes on current news and events. I wanted to ask your opinion on the Cannon Hennett situation and the media's initial lack of reporting. Well, it's very easy to explain that. First of all, what he says, talking about Cannon Hennett, that's the little 5-year-old white boy. He was shot in the head point blank, riding his bike into his black neighbor's yard. That guy turns out to be a pedophile. What I don't understand is, the guy went out with a kid's dad to lunch like a bitch.